Hello and welcome to another update video about Bitcoin. Bitcoin has been moving up this week. It's fairly bullish price action. It basically turned around exactly where it needed to do that in our yellow trend reversal area that was on the chart for months. The movement to the downside has been very corrective. You see a lot of price action which is sort of overlapping, which is very much a sign for corrective price action. The movement to the upside has been impulsive, and also the latest move to the upside has been impulsive. So we have a potentially still incomplete, but potentially also complete impulse to the upside in a wave one. This could cascade higher, obviously, right? So we are looking currently for bullish price action. This is a very exciting time. We bottomed here possibly in this wave two. My assumption is now that we are in the wave three. The assumption is this assumption, as long as we're holding 26,190. This is really the key bullish support. I showed you that bullish range in the last video. Against that level, the focus can be on higher. 26,190, very important level. The idea is that obviously we have this 1-2 setup, and next price could head to 30K. Well, we are at 40K. Yeah, and beyond in a third wave. A third wave is usually very aggressive. So it is exactly the moment now where things could get really, really interesting. Well, not today, not tomorrow, maybe next week, maybe the week after. We will see, but I don't think it will take too long if this is the correct wave count. I mean, there's always a potential, you know, I get the structure wrong. But that's exactly why we deal with the pivot points. And I'll tell you exactly the level where I am going to be wrong, yeah, which is 26,190. A break below that level would not change the underlying assumption that we are in a 1-2 setup, because the fallback scenario would still be bullish and would allow for a reset of wave 2 a little lower. And we only have an A wave down, a B wave up, and the C wave down. But note that this would still be bullish and could result in a third wave later, as long as we're holding this bullish support level at 22K. But also note that it would completely crush the altcoins if Bitcoin is not able to hold support here and breaks down another. Well, where would it take us roughly from here? Bitcoin would probably lose around 25%. That would really, really crush the altcoins. I mean, you don't really want to see that happen, to be honest. But it can, of course, right? I've seen stuff like that. But primary expectation is at the moment that wave two bottomed here on the 15th of June. We're now moving higher. I sincerely hope everybody's got a position. We had a lot of time. I don't think this is bearish. People still talk about a bear market. I don't know where these people have been in the last 6 months, because our money has basically doubled since the November low. In an environment in which interest rates have increased, yeah, the Fed is now stopping the rate increase, at least for now, temporarily. You know, and people use that now as news that that is the reason why price did go up. But price did go up in an interest rate, in an environment in which interest rates have been increased, okay? So is it really still a bear market? I want to challenge that assumption. But we've been talking about that anyway for many months now, that probably this bear market low was already in. Nevertheless, I cannot rule out that we still get another bear market low. You know that typically after the Fed pivots and reduces interest rates again, there is usually a bit of a collapse. Yeah. And now we just simply haven't got enough data in the crypto market to suggest that it will, you know, that it will affect the crypto market as well. You just can't say that. Crypto is just too young. So, but it's just something we need to be aware of. That's all the stuff I'm watching for in addition to the analysis here. But yeah, it's pretty bullish price action. I mean, we're holding bullish support. Could it be bearish? Yes, but there's no point focusing on a bearish scenario as long as we're holding bullish support. There's just no reason we are in an uptrend. You can talk about people manipulate the market or whatever, but it is just an uptrend. You know, we've doubled, really, prices doubled since November, and it's pretty, pretty good within a year, right? Not even within basically half a year. So it's pretty good. zooming in a little bit here, we are possibly, yeah, and that is sort of the expectation at the moment, at the start of a third wave rally, here in yellow. First of all, though, it seems likely to get a deeper pullback in a wave two. Now, again, what I wouldn't do is sell everything here and, you know, wait until prices go down to 26K to go all in, because prices may not come down that much. That's why I gave you the range to trade earlier today. How you trade, this is, of course, up to you. I can really only give you the parameters against which you can trade. Can't really tell you what to do, but I sincerely hope everybody's got a core position, because what usually happens is that in a third wave, pullbacks are less deep than people expect. It could go directly, yeah. We don't need that deep pullback. I just want to make that very clear again. As I said down here, when Bitcoin is turning around, it can be fast. I know Bitcoin didn't move in massive ways in this week, but it still surprised a lot of people. So I just want to highlight again that pullbacks can be shallow in a wave three, and price action can rally quickly. Typically in a third wave, it takes off. The train takes off with a few people only, okay? Because people, I don't know, they are too late. They haven't realized it, that we could be in this third wave. And I'm not telling you we definitely are, but that's exactly why we analyze, to identify potential, okay? So yeah, I sincerely hope everybody has a position. Everybody's sort of on the train, not still waiting at the station. Again, it's the concept of having a core position versus floating positions. The core position is certainly there to help you to stay on the train in a third wave rally. And I can't tell you how big it is supposed to be. That depends on you and your psychology and your attitude, right? And, you know, your portfolio basically. But I find a core position very reasonable at the moment. Now, looking at this structure here, we have a possible wave one to the upside, a wave two, a wave three. And this is now the question. Few possibilities here, and we can talk about them. Yeah, just be aware that obviously we don't know which one it is, but there are two support levels, 28,546. As long as that level is holding, I would assume we still get a fifth wave to the upside, which could be unfolding right now. Yeah, it might very well be that we are unfolding here this wave five as an ending diagonal, because it's very choppy. It could be that we are in the wave four still and come down currently in this yellow wave count in a C wave, but it would still lead to a wave five later. But below 28,546, I assume we are already in the larger wave two and finished wave one already. So this is the uncertainty we deal with. 26,190 is at the moment bullish support. So potentials here at the moment are that we're dealing with a wave four as a flat pattern, expanded flat, A wave down in three waves, B waves up in three waves, and the C wave should, however, come down quite impulsively in an expanded or running flat structure going into the yellow support area again. Or alternatively, we have completed wave four here, the alternate. Yeah, okay, maybe wave five is already in, or wave five is still unfolding as an ending diagonal. That would be a wave one, a wave two, a wave three, four, five, something like that in wave five. That's all possible, especially as long as we're holding the trend line, and as long as we're holding 28,546. Yeah, that's my update about Bitcoin. I hope you will like the update. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment and subscribe. And if you really like the content, then please check out the channel membership. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.